So I recently purchased some tapes from tapeheadcity.com in celebration of picking up a new deck to go in the system. A little backstory. I had a great deck in the system and it got struck by lightning along with a large amount of electronics here in this house. TVs, PlayStations, camera, the power supply to the PC here, my super VHS player, rest in peace. So anyway, for over a year, I've been on the lookout for a new tape deck to go in the system. I didn't go to the normal places like Facebook Marketplace or Craigslist, only looking in thrift stores and Goodwills because that's just kind of how I roll. And it took me just over a year and I ran across this little gem, the Realistic SCP-30 from 1988. I actually thought this was an alarm clock when I stumbled across it in a Goodwill for $5. I plugged it up, the thing turned, so I was like, maybe we'll be in business here. I did a quick little Google search to find that people actually covet this little monster machine. I've never used the word cute to describe a piece of electronics, but this damn thing is just too cute. It's a single player, no record head, and if you don't know Realistic, that was the house brand of Radio Shack back in the day. And they actually made some pretty decent stuff. And people actually kind of covet this thing and said, it sounds pretty good. And that's good enough for me. Let's be honest, when we're talking about tape decks, fidelity is not, that's really, you know, I don't want a piece of junk, but also if I'm looking for audiophile quality, I'll go get the latest and greatest vinyl pressing, the UHQRC or Fi. Shit. Having picked this up for $5, I was really happy with it. And to celebrate, I wanted to pick up some tapes. I remember Jay talking about tapeheadcity.com, so I went and checked it out. And I went a little hard and bought some cool stuff. I bought some weirdo stuff and some stuff that would be what would be considered in my wheelhouse, like in Stoner Doom. And I was kind of surprised to find that they had quite a bit of stuff in the Stoner Doom genre there. And the cool thing about this is because a lot of records in the Stoner Doom genre, which is kind of my wheelhouse, a lot of the records go out of print, or they're really hard to find, or they're super expensive, or all of the above. And this was this is definitely the case with some of the ones I was lucky enough to pick up on cassette. I'm going to do some, we'll talk about these and we'll jump into some needle drops as well. First up, we'll start with the weird. I saw this, they do have a used tape section, and I had to peruse through there. It was very light, there wasn't a bunch of stuff in there. One thing I did see was an Oldsmobile tape, complimentary tape cartridge from Oldsmobile. Okay, what is this? So what this ends up being is if you bought an Oldsmobile in 1985, this cassette came with your car, and it's got a lot of like pop and country radio hits on it. So it's like a mixtape. You got Cyndi Lauper, you got Enrique Iglesias with Willie Nelson, you got some Barbara Streisand, you got some country stuff on there, and then there's some. There's another tape that's got a bunch of like classical music and stuff like that on it. But anyway, the reason I bought it is the first song on here is the Oldsmobile theme song. It was $2. Had to grab it. Check it out.
There is a special feeling in Oldsmobile. There is a special feeling in Oldsmobile. More than the luxury ride, it's a feeling of pride that you feel inside.
Stumbled across this little gem and going through the website, a tape I bought just sheerly based on the name alone. It's Shit Horse. It's on a green tape. Cool. And the name of this album is They Shit Horses, Don't They? So I had to pick this up. Come to find out, this is a 2010 debut by Shit Horse, the only tape they've got out. And they're from Chapel Hill, North Carolina. That's about 45 minutes down the road. And I saw some live footage of these guys playing at the Cat's Cradle. You would call it maybe lo-fi, indie, punk. It's crazy. Jesus Christ. I have no idea how to describe these guys. But just know that their stage show, there was a guy running around with a horse on his head. There was a chick with her knockers hanging out. The singer's like an older black dude, with gray in his beard and shit. And it's something else. I really enjoyed what I saw of them live, and I can't wait to check this tape out. Let's do it together right now.
I wish you 12 horses when you die. I wish you 12 horses when you die. I wish you 12 horses when you die. I want to be standing on the sky. I wish you 12 horses.
So that was Shit Horse with their 2010 record. They shit horses, don't they? On Odessa Records from Chapel Hill. I've ran across Psychiatric Metaphors. No clue. And I bought two tapes from them, actually. Both of these are from 2015 on King Pizza Records. And they describe themselves as psychedelic punk rock, which I don't know if I've ever heard. And it's rings pretty true. Really interesting band. I think they're from New Jersey. And white tape and clear tape. Ooh, clear tape, bruh. But yeah, I got the Seeker and 33 Thorn Street. So I tell you what, let's listen to a sample from one of these right now to give you an idea of what they sound like. This is Psychiatric Metaphors. Into the Stoner Doom stuff that I picked up. All these tapes up to this point, I paid, well, the Oldsmobile was $2, but the rest of them were like $5 or $6. And so with the Stoner Doom stuff, I ended up taking some chances on some stuff, and they were probably around $9. I think they're right at $9. And the only one I knew of, I'd heard of before, was this band here, Clouds Taste Satanic. This is their record, Old Magic Records. What's the name of the album? Second Sight. I knew these guys. These guys are pretty famous in the Stoner Doom community for being, they call it like post-industrial doom or something like that. They're out of Brooklyn, New York, and have a pretty good reputation. I knew enough to take a stab on this. It's one of those where you're not going to find that record floating around your local shop, more than likely, unless you just live in an absolute record mecca. Definitely worth checking out, and I knew it was worth taking a stab on. So let's take a listen to Clouds Taste Satanic, Second Sight. Up next is Marmalade Knives, so killer name to begin with, and this is their album Amnesia, and it's on the Italian label Electric Valley. These guys are out of Santa Cruz, California, I believe. One of the Santas in California, and I've never heard of them before. Checked them out. They are Stoner Doom, but a lot more on the psychedelic side of things, I would say, and I don't want to make that a misnomer, because there is some quality riffage in there. There's some passages that seem like they're a little heavy on the wah pedal. So think more like Nebula or Earthless versus like a Caius or a or Fu Manchu necessarily, that kind of stuff. So really interested to check this out. It's almost progressive at times for the little bits that I sampled. So Marmalade Knives, and again, what a killer freaking name. These guys, I just knew from the cover. I knew from the cover that Electric Mountain was going to be fantastic. Now, I'd not heard of these guys. I was kind of surprised. They're from Mexico City. And this is the only one. Like, you can actually, you could buy this record right now for $23-24 on their Bandcamp. It's the only one that's, like, still available. But I bought it anyway because this was $9. I figured it was cool to take a chance. And I'm kind of eat up with buying tapes right now. You know what I mean? So this is some quality riffage. This is definitely like Caius or Fu Manchu, or I heard a lot of like that straightforward da-na-na-na-na-na-na-na, almost motoric beat. So even think of Truck Fighters in a way, if you've ever heard the Truck Fighters. So Electric Mountain, really looking forward to check this out. Straightforward, hard fuzz. And let's check some out right now. Finally, I don't know what made me even look at this. I mean, probably the cover art. The cover art probably did this for me here. Because it looked really metally and stuff. But it is a stoner. It is a Stoner Doom a group. Acid Magus. M-A-G-U-S. But the name of the album is Word Sister. But look at how Word Sister is spelled. That's pretty crazy. And I just kind of taken this. Oh, this looks like a clear tape, but a different kind of, maybe a little colored clear tape. That's kind of cool. These guys are actually from South Africa. And I don't think I've ever heard any Stoner Doom stuff from South Africa. So I'm really looking forward to checking this out. They describe themselves as Garage Doom on Shrooms. Say less. Let's check out Acid Magus. Really happy to get this new deck and put it into the system and be able to play my old tapes I've had in the collection, plus be able to pick some new ones up and be able to enjoy them. I've had a lot of fun doing it. This was supposed to be the year of the 7-inch and the tape for me, because I'm out of room for LPs. but it's been fun to do this, and I look forward to doing a little more. Also, shouts to Tapehead City, cool website, and they sent me some cool stickers, which we also always dig here. You know that shit. So. Thanks, everybody, for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one. Peace.